myself Ramesh Reddy, working as associate professor in the department of ECE. So today I am going to explain about the convolution in digital signal processing. Convolution and its various types. Okay. So let us consider a discrete time system. So with input as x of n and output as y of n, and here with impulse response h of n. Okay. So generally convolution means we think of it as a mathematical relation, right? So but actually convolution is the mathematical tool which is going to evaluate the response of the system, or in fact it is going to relate the input and the output of the system with the impulse response of the system. Okay, right? So here we relate y of t or y of n, in case it is a discrete system, y of n is equal to x of n convolved with h of n. So that means we are relating the impulse response, input and output. So the output is expressed as a convolution of the input and impulse response of the system, right? So in case for a continuous time systems is concerned, so we are going to write the relation as, so y of t is equal to, for continuous time systems, so integral minus infinite to plus infinite x of tau into h of t minus tau beta. So this is the expression for the continuous time convolution. For the continuous, if the system, given system is continuous time in the domain, so the output can be expressed as a convolution of t2, or input signal as well as the impulse response of the system in continuous time systems. Right. So here actually integration, it is going to evaluate the common area under these two signals. So x of x input and the impulse response, what is the common area? So that is going to be evaluated by this, which will be nothing but the response of the system. In case for our discrete time systems, so y of n we can write as, so summation, let's say L is equal to minus infinite to plus infinite. So it is x of L into h of n minus L. So this way we are going to represent the discrete time convolution. Okay, right? So for the continuous time convolution is concerned, we have only one type, that is expressing the common area under the two signals, that is input signal and impulse response. But whereas for discrete time systems, the convolution, we have two types. So one is linear convolution and second one as circular convolution. So two types of convolutions we try to evaluate for the discrete time systems. So based on the length of the sequence, when you are talking about discrete time system, we talk about what is the length of the input sequence and what is the length of impulse response and what is the supposed length of the output sequence we are going to get from the discrete time system. So linear convolution, how we are going to evaluate? So when you are talking about linear convolution, right? So let us take x of n as the input sequence, let's say length as L. So what L indicates here is the number of discrete instance we take for the x of n. Okay. Similarly, h of n, the impulse response is of length, let's say m. Right? So from the linear convolution, we are going to get the output length, y of n length will be L plus n minus 1. So that means, so number of samples present in x of n and number of samples present in h of n minus 1. So that will be the overall length of the output sequence of the linear convolution. Okay. But when it comes to circular convolution, so while evaluating circular convolution, so we are going to take, so for the same example, if you take example in having the length L and h of n impulse response having the length m samples, so then we are going to make the these two lengths as equal. Okay, so that means circular convolution evaluation requires length of the two sequences which are to be convolved should have same number of samples. That means n should be equal to m. If not that, suppose that if you have, let's say, for example, if L has, let's say, 3 samples and then m has, let's say, 5 samples, for example, then what we are going to do, in order for making these two equal, so we are going to add, so 2 zeros for the x of n. That means, so m minus l, that means 5 minus 3, we are going to, the 2 zeros are going to be padded for the length of the sequence x of n. Okay, so that means, in order for performing circular convolution, the two length of sequences should have equal number of samples, right? If not equal, we have to add zeros for the sequence which has a less number of samples, okay? So, in order for making them equal, in here, for this example, we are required to add 2 zeros for this sequence so that length becomes 5 here and 5 here, okay? Right? So, this is regarding circular convolution. How do we evaluate both? When it comes to linear convolution, we are using the expression, so y of n is equal to, let's say, n is equal to minus infinite plus infinite, some kind of summation, x of n, h of n minus n. So that we evaluate the linear convolution. Okay, but coming to circular convolution, how we are going to perform, So let us discuss, we have two methods here for performing circular convolution. So to perform circular convolution, so we have two methods that we are going to follow. First one is matrix method. One and second one as concentric circle method. Okay. So let us see matrix method first. So let us take an example so that we can understand easily about how to perform circular convolution using matrix. Let us take x of n is equal to, I'm taking, let's say, 1 comma minus 1 to, let's say, 0 and 3, for example. And impulse response as h of n is equal to, let's say, it is 1 comma 2 comma 3. So that means we have here, so the length of input sequence L is equal to 5, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements are there, so L is equal to 5. And the length of the impulse response M is equal to 3, so 3 elements are there. But for performing circular convolution, we require both the sequences to be same length. So what we have to do in order to make, so padding zeros, we are going to pad zeros for h of n. So in order to make the length equal. So that means x of n will be as it is, but h of n, how many zeros we have to add? How many zeros we are required to pad in order to become 5?
So therefore, here we are going to add zeros, two zeros we are going to add. Okay. Right? So now the length of x of n and length of h of n is same. Okay? So now, how we represent in matrix method to find out. So y of n is equal to so x of n convolution with h of n as we know. So for circular convolution in matrix method, so we are going to write that h of n in circular shift manner. That means we are going to write 1, 2, 3, 0, 0. So that means the second segment, h of n, we are writing 1, 2, 3, 0, 0, we have. Right? So we are written in vertical first column. Then one position we are going to shift cyclically. We are going to cyclically shift one position. That means this 0 comes here. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 0. Right? And one more time again. Next, so we'll have 0, 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Then next it will be 3, 0, 0, 1, 2. And finally, we'll have one more. So 2, 3, 0, 0, 1. Now here we are going to stop, because one more time if you make cyclically shift, you are going to get the first column itself, right? So this is going to be like a 5 by 5 matrix. And second sequence we are going to write in a column matrix, the first sequence. So that is 1, minus 1, 2, 0 and 3. So this is a matrix which we have. So this is h of n we are writing, and this is x of n, and the output, the product of these two matrices will form the output y of n. So that means you can have like, so 1 into 1 plus 1 into 3, 6, 8 will be like 7, the first element, then second row. So 2 into 1, 2 minus 1, so 1, then 3 into 9, so 10. So like that we are going to evaluate the 5 elements, so which will be nothing but the y of n is the response of the system using the circular convolution using matrix method. Okay, by matrix method, this way we are going to find out the response of the system. So that means first and foremost thing is, like, when based on the given two sequences, we are going to make the length of the two sequences equal by adding zeros to the sequence which has less in length. And then writing that second sequence, this h of n, we are going to write in a circular shift manner in the matrix, in the column matrix. First column we are write as it is. Then cyclically we are going to shift one position until we get the first column as it is. Okay, right. So then writing the x of n in the column matrix, then simply perform matrix multiplication, we are going to get the sequence which is nothing but the output, right? Output of the circular convolution. Okay. So then now we have second method, that is concentric circles method. So for the same example, if you go A, so what we are going to take in either of the two methods, both sequences should have same number of points or number of samples. So for that case only we have added zeros. So these two are only will be taken, like x1, x2. Okay. So the first step is, so we are going to draw a circle, right? And starting at one point, so we are going to write like this as x of 0, okay, then x of 1. So how many we have represented? 5. So So x of 1, x of 2, x of 3 and x of 4. Okay. So we are representing the sequence x of n, so in the outer circle by starting at what